Tomorrow marks 20 years since the day that changed the US and the world forever.
Some breaking news just through, and CNN is reporting tonight that a plane has crashed into the World Trade Center.
A series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts. The victims were in airplanes or in their offices, secretaries, businessmen and women, military and federal workers, moms and dads, friends and neighbors. Today, our nation saw evil, the very worst of human nature. And we responded with the best of America.
To mark the historic event, 10 News First is telling the stories of Australians linked to the tragedy in a new 9/11 special, In the Shadow of the Towers. Take a look.
Details now on this breaking story.
Oh, my God, another plane has just hit.
He rang me, knowing that Mum was on holidays. He said, I think that's one of them. So I think that's one of the planes.
It was horrific that day.
Oh my goodness, there is smoke pouring out of the Pentagon.
Oh, God. The dominant concern was that there would be another attack.
10 News First, Sandra Sully broke the news to Australia, and she's also one of the hosts of tomorrow night's special, and she joins us now. It's hard even watching all these years later, those pictures, isn't it?
It's hard to believe, 20 years, and yet it's so vivid, isn't it? I think we all know where we were that day. We all do.
Absolutely. We lost 10 Australians in the attack. You spoke to Simon Kennedy. He's an Aussie comedian. He's been on our show a few times. Lovely fella. His mum, Yvonne, was on one of the planes that crashed into the Pentagon. Let's have a look at part of that interview.
And it was my brother, who was living in London at the time. He rang me and said, look, some planes have hit some buildings in America. I'm a bit worried about Mum. Can you check and tell us where she is or where she's meant to be? And I said, she's supposed to be getting on a plane, American Airlines Flight 77. And he said, I think that's one of them. So he said, I think that's one of the planes. I've been asked what I miss the most about not having her around now. Having a grandmother for the kids would be really great. She would have been a great grandmother, and that would have been beautiful to see.
Breaks your heart, doesn't it? What other stories did he share about his mum?
Well, I think, the emotional journey of anyone losing their mum, but also for him coming to terms with what happened. And he was invited back a year later for a memorial, and he also went to Guantanamo Bay to see the masterminds of the hijackings and what that meant to him and how he came to terms with vengeance versus being, seeing this mastermind, terrorist, really with pity, saying, look, you really didn't achieve anything. Mm. And I think that's been a wonderful journey for him, but it also... he's been very courageous in sharing that zeal of patriotism that happened after September 11, when there was, it spawned a lot of racism and anti-Muslim behaviour. And he said, before 9/11, I really didn't have any Muslim friends, and it spawned a lot of hate. And so he's been very vocal in trying to shut that down and remind people that, that they don't represent the Muslim community, just as, the KKK don't represent the Caucasian and American society. So, lots of good stories. And, of course, it touched everyone worldwide. The world changed on a sixpence or a dime, depending where you come from, that minute. And so we share their stories. It's fascinating.
It's definitely one of those events that people always remember where they were. The terror attack, on September 11 is arguably one of the most important stories that you've talked about. You actually broke the story here to the country. We can take a look at it here.
Some breaking news just through, and CNN is reporting tonight that a plane has crashed into the World Trade Center. We can now confirm a second plane has crashed into the second tower of the World Trade Center. Goodness me, I'm sorry. You can see there the second tower, it does appear, may well have been collapsing. It does appear that it has collapsed. We're not sure whether it is the first or the second tower. A major catastrophe in the United States.
I still remember my mum calling me in the middle of the night saying, quick, turn on 10, Sandra Sully's got some big news, and watching that unfold. What was it like for you, kind of anchoring that on the other side of the world and kind of trying to get your head around?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of people may have heard the story by now, but, you know, I was here basically alone. You know, I had a friend floor managing and Sports Tonight, Tim Webster and a couple of people were here, but the newsroom was pretty much empty. And I just remember this sort of virtual seatbelt coming across me, and I, you know, sat there for hours. And, you know, we've got a couple of generations of people that really don't have any comprehension. They keep hearing that it was the day that changed the world. But I remind people, in a modern sort of context, it would have been like watching the Christchurch shootings live for 6 hours and the trauma and aftermath of that. So for me at the time, wires went dead. I had no wire copy. I couldn't get any information other than scrambling for information from CNN in my earpiece. But I was on air for 5 or 6 hours with no detail, but it did feel like the beginning of World War III. Mm. And so, you know, when you had a terrorist strike in the heart of the US democracy, the financial hub of the Western world, you know, it was seismic, and it was the magnitude of it. I was just grappling constantly to try and capture it without inciting panic, just sort of saying to people, ring your family, ring your friends, this is monumental. Mm. And this will change the world forever, right now. And all of Australians woke up, you know, blithely until that point, enjoying hiding in the Southern Hemisphere, having this idyllic island state. And we were global citizens the next morning, and terror had a tentacle, you know, the worldwide wide reach. And we all felt that. From that day on, the world changed.
It certainly did.
Well, In the Shadow of the Towers airs tomorrow, September 11, at 6 p.m. It's only on 10 and 10 Play on demand. Sandra Sully, thanks for your time today. Looking forward to watching that tomorrow night.
Thank you.